I was married for about 18 years. I know I look young, but my husband, we got married when I was about, 18 years old, and I know we're both small town people, so it seemed like the right thing to do. It'd be good. Cranked out some kids, and shit got weird. Like, he started, like, on the internet a lot, just hanging out, and I was real glad that he got friends, because he wasn't a real social dude, you know. Over the years, like, kids took their toll, and drained the life out of him or something. Anyway, and I did ask, like, are you okay? He'd be like, I'm fine. Okay. You know, and I'm cool, too, because he's not up my ass all the time, so awesome. Well, then one of my kids says, he's up late at night, you know, and he's like, I don't know, the kids are like, one of my oldest son, he goes, is Dad gay? And I was like, that would explain a lot. You know, like, could be, I don't know. And I don't ask, I don't talk to him too much, so I don't fucking know. Well, then Christopher says, well, I'm asking because he was up late at night talking to that dude that he talks to in Australia named Elliot. I was like, what? Okay. And he said, but he was talking like real romantic with Elliot. And I said, oh, I'm going to call your dad because this is fucking weird. So I call up my husband and I said, hey, the kids are curious if you're gay. That's cool. And so whatever. And then he said no. He said, but he is talking to a friend named Elliot and is actually a lady, but he didn't want anybody to freak out. And is this okay? And I said, well, is she going to move here and, like, help us clean or something? Because our fucking house is a mess. I need some help. And he said, no, it's not like that. Like, we just talk on the phone and we chat and, you know, she's a friend that I met on StarTrek.com. And I said, cool, okay, at least you've got somebody that, you know, you're talking to, because it ain't me, so that's fine. And I'm not threatened by her. I was like, you're not leaving me for her or nothing? Like, we're not, should we work on stuff? What's going on? And he was like, no, everything's okay. I'm okay. I just really like her, and we play this, like, little fantasy, you know, like, role-playing thing. And I was like, you know, after 18 years of marriage, whatever. Okay. So everything was fine. And then one day he says, hey, I did something crazy. And I go, weirder than that? Like, talking to this lady on StarTrek.com? And he goes, well, actually, I got a ticket to Australia, and I'm going to go visit her. And I was like, oh, my God, you're leaving me for a woman you met on StarTrek.com? I'm a comedian, and that's kind of awesome. That's great, because I was like, I'm going to get material out of this. But I was devastated. Kind of, mostly devastated. And I freaked out, and I got really upset, and then he packed up his bags, and he went to Australia, and I was following him. Like, I said, bitch, I'm not taking you to the fucking airport. You got another thing coming. And I was just following him behind him in the minivan while he's walking the bus stop with bags to go to Australia for the StarTrek.com lady. What? My whole life is just falling apart. And then I go home, and I freak out, and I stay in bed for a long time because I don't know what to do, and I was really upset, and then I go through and I hack his email. I get in, you know, because I know his social security number and his mom's maiden name. Fuck it. I got in there, and I found all these emails. She sent one 10-year-old pic. He was going to Australia sight unseen. He'd never even seen this woman before. And he was just going. That's how unhappy he was. So, okay, fine. But I called her. I kept calling her because I found her number. And finally, she got me on the phone, and then she said, I'll go get Brad. Brad was his name, but she called him Brad because they talk like garbage. Australians have the worst fucking terrible accent. And she just put the phone down. What a bitch! She never went and got him. I was on the phone for hours. Okay, so then finally this fucker, after 3 weeks, he comes home to our home and acts like nothing happened. Like, you know, hey, I got the kids a boomerang. I came back, haha. What? So then So then finally she calls me back once he comes home. And she says, "Kristine, why are you harassing me?" Because Australian, I don't know if you know this, but the Australians are the hillbillies of the British Empire. And that fucking accent. Blah. Okay. So, why are you harassing me? I'm like, what are you doing to my family? Why? We're married. What's wrong with you? And she goes, "Oh, he told me you'd say that." I was like, oh my God. No, we really are still married, and this is a big deal. What are you doing? And she goes, "Well, you're fit, and I'm rather slender. And Brad tells me you're doing this comedy thing, but you're not really funny." I was like, man, you can say I'm fat, but fuck, what? What? So I take off running down the hall. I go into Brad's office, and I go, "What is this? This fucking bitch, you tell her I'm not funny?" And then he talks to her for a minute. He says, "I'm sorry," closes his phone. Then a few days later, Brad tried to kill himself. He cut his wrists open, and he bled all over our house, and our kids found him. And then I went, and we took him to the loony bin and put him in the hospital because he's crazy. And because he felt bad. He was guilty, you know, and he just cut his wrists open, and it was crazy, and the kids were, it was awful. And then, but while he was in the loony bin, I went and filed for divorce from this guy because you don't fucking do that to my kids, man. So, like, for better or worse, but not that. And then I called up this woman while he was up in the nut hut, and I called up her. Her name was Anita, and I called Anita, and I said, "Anita, I'm so sorry for everything that I put you guys through. You are right. You and Brad belong together," and he moved out, and here's the number for where he's staying now. And she said, "Well, I'm so glad you finally come to your senses." And I said, "Oh, yeah, I have. She calls me back in like 5 minutes and she goes, "Is Brad in a mental hospital?" And I said, "Don't you ever fucking tell me I'm not funny."